Hello my dear students, welcome again for the today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture we are going to learn the concept reducing fractions to the lowest term. Reducing fraction to the lowest term means what? Reducing means to make it less, least. Okay, so the fractions which are given there, we have to find its lowest term. Lowest term in sense, we have to find its equivalent fraction which is lowest. Okay, lowest term means it is its equivalent fraction only, but it is lowest. And whenever we find equivalent fraction, if you remember, which two ways we use equivalent fraction, either we can find by using multiplication or by division. Okay, so here we have to find lowest term, smallest value, smallest equivalent fraction, so that we have to divide. We have to use here which way? Division. Understood? To find the lowest term, remember, all keep it in mind, to find lowest term of the fraction, which way we have to use? Division. Okay, we have to go by which way? Division way. Understood? That means what? How we found equivalent fraction? Using division. Remember, we divide it, both the numerator and denominator, by same number. Okay, so first of all we have to find such number by which both numerator and denominators are divisible. See the first example here in the practice 5.10. See the first example, 10 upon 22. This is the given fraction and we have to find its lowest term, smallest term. Okay, that means we have to reduce it, and to reduce it we have to find such number by which we can divide both the numerator and denominator. Now see here, 10 and 22 are in which table? 10 and 22 are in which table of same number? There should be both 10 and 22. Okay, 10 is in table of 2. Is the 22 in table of 2? Or is 22 divisible by 2? Yes, because its last digit is 2, that means it is divisible by 2. Table means, see here once again, table means what? Not till 10s are, it can be 11s are, 12s are, 13s are, uncountable. Okay, so both 10 and 22 are divisible by 2, that is 10 upon 22 divide by 2, divide by 2. Okay, so 2 tens are 10 divided by 2, 2 multiplied by how many? 10. 2 5s are 10, correct? Upon 22 divided by 2, when we will divide 22 by 2, what answer we will get? 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, 11. Okay, so 5 upon 11. Further, check whether 5 and 11 are any same table except 1. Except 1, why? Because if you divide 1, all numbers are in table of 1, and if you divide 1, divide by 1 to both the numerator and denominator, we will get same number as answer. Okay, so except 1, check whether 5 and 11 are divisible by any common number. Is it there? No. So this is only the lowest term of 10 upon 22. Understood? What we have done? We have divided both the numerator and denominator by same number. Remember once again, the number by which you are going to divide, it should be same. Here there is 2 and here there is 3. No way. This is not allowed. The number by which you will divide numerator, by same number you have to divide to the denominator. Understood? So first you have to check whether by which number both the numerator and denominators are divisible, and we have got here that 10 and 22 are divisible by 2, so we have divided both the numbers by 2 and we got 2 5s are 10, 2 11s are 22. Understood? Next, second, 18 upon 33. Now think that 18 and 33 are divisible by which same number? 18 is in table of 2, but 33 is not divisible by 2 because last digit is 3. 18 is in table of 3. Is 33 divisible by 3? Yes, because not last digit is 3, not because of last digit is 3, sum of the digits 3 plus 3 6 and 6 is divisible by 3, so 33 is also divisible by 3. Everything what we have learned till now is useful. If you have learned the divisibility test thoroughly, then it will be easy for you. Divisibility test we are going to use everywhere in the maths, okay? 18 divided by 3, 3 6 are 18, right? And 33 divided by 3, 3 11s are 33, 3 1s are 3, 3 1s are 3. 6 upon 11, okay? Further, 6 upon 11 are divisible by any common number except 1? No. So, 6 upon 11 is the reduced form of 18 upon 33. Next. 55 upon 35. Now, check whether 55 and 35 are divisible by which same number. Last digit is 5, so they are divisible by 5. Divide by 5, divide by 5. 55 divided by 5, 55 divided by 5, 5 ones are 5. 5 ones are 5. What answer we got? 11. 55 divided by 5, 11 upon 35 divided by 5. 5 sevens are 35, okay? 11 upon 7. Again, 11 upon 7 is not divisible by any other same number, common number. So, 11 upon 7 is itself the reduced form of 55 upon 35, okay? 54 upon 90, fourth one example is 54 upon 90. Now check, both 54 and 90 are in which same table or are divisible by which same number? Getting? They are in the table of 9. So divide by 9, divide by 9. 54 divided by 9, 9, 6 are 54. Upon 90 divided by 9, 9 tens are, correct? Now again see, 6 and 10, 6 upon 10. Again 6 upon 10 are divisible by any same number? Are 6 and 10 in any same number of table of number? Is there 6 upon 10? Yes, they are in table of 2. That is 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10, 2 5s are 10, okay? Again 3 and 5 are in any same table except 1? No. So 3 upon 5, 3 5th is the reduced form of 54 upon 90. Understood? We have to keep on dividing till we get such fraction which is further not divisible by any common number, okay? Fifth one, 55 upon 88. Immediately you can tell by which number both 55 and 88 are divisible. If you know the tables, they are in table of 11. 55 divided by 11, 11 5s are 55 and 11 8s are 88, right? So 5 upon 8, further 5 upon 8, 5 and 8 are there in any same table? No. So 5 8th is the reduced form of 55 upon 88, understood? So in this way, we have to find lowest form, lowest term or smallest term, we can say, of given fraction. We have to divide both the numerator and denominator by same number, and which is that number that we have to find, okay? Pause this video, write these 5 examples. There are only 5 examples in the practice 5.10. Even though I am giving some examples for homework, do that. Continue with the next number, example number 6. Sixty-four upon 48. 95 upon 57, ninth one 110 upon 60, and tenth one 58 upon, take here 54 upon 27. Okay, so these 5 examples you have to solve by yourself. Understood? I hope you have understood this concept of reducing fraction to the lowest term. If you have any doubt in this, you're free to ask. So thank you for today and have a nice day.